Bloomberg headquarters in New York. This is Market Makers with Eric Schatzker and Stephanie Ruhle.
Welcome back to Market Makers. I'm Stephanie Ruhle. As New York Fashion Week kicks into high gear, more young celebrities are walking the concrete catwalk in shoes designed by an unexpected luxury shoe designer. In a market dominated by European men like Louboutin, Giuseppe, Manolo Blahnik, Rihanna and Beyonce are choosing to pound the pavement in an American shoe designer, Ruthie Davis's shoes. She's here with us to explain why. Ruthie, how did you get into this market? A woman from Connecticut makes a giant splash in avant-garde luxury shoes, a market dominated by Europeans.
My first job in the industry was actually working at Reebok, and a lot of men worked at Reebok, and I always just, I don't know, I felt like one of the guys. I never thought of it like a woman designing shoes, a man designing shoes, and I just always was very aggressive and in my ideas and bold, and I just never saw anything holding me back.
How do you go, though?
You may not feel as though you're different from the guys, but
right.
Your customers may feel that you're different. Do you think that being a female shoe designer helps you win an audience among women who want to wear nice shoes?
Yes, and the reason, actually, to answer your question, Beyonce, Lady Gaga, Rihanna, they love to wear my shoes because they can perform in them. They're comfortable.
Eric, could you
they
perform
can wear
in these?
Very,
oh, most definitely.
Eric could.
Yeah, I think I'd look great. they can wear a really high shoe because girls love their heels, but they're also comfortable because I'm a woman designing for women. I test drive them. I wear them. I work really hard in Italy making sure that they're comfortable even though they're high.
Why do you need to make the shoes in Italy? What's the hook?
Luxury shoes, it's artisan work. It's made by hand. It's the best quality, the best materials, the best workmanship. And when you're in the luxury category, that's critical.
And how did they find you? I mean, there has to be an extraordinary amount of women that think, I could design amazing shoes. How did you do it and get the likes of a Gaga, a Rihanna, to see and fall in love with your stuff?
It's just, you start in the beginning, you have your team. Like, I've always had people that help me in, like, public relations or marketing. And at the end of the day, I always say it comes back to the product. These ladies liked my shoes. You know, they're given a whole group of shoes to choose from when they pick their outfits. And at the end of the day, they have to actually like your shoe. So I feel fortunate that I've had, great shoes. I mean, it's difficult to make it in a market. You know, I'm a smaller company competing, like you said, with huge Uber brands, but I focus on the product, the quality, the fit, and personally, I think they look amazing. So
they do.
These girls, they know what they want, and they pick my shoes.
How do you feel about flats?
You know what? I'm really, flats are great. There's no problem with flats, but for me,
hold on.
Like,
there's no flats, and still, even your sneaker.
I know.
Has 6 inches on.
You know, I always say the story. I was the youngest of six kids, and I was shorter than everybody. And I just think, from a young age, I just realized that a heel makes you taller, and it makes you feel more powerful. And as a woman, I like to be tall.
How is social media? You have a massive Instagram following from shoe enthusiasts, fetishists, I don't know who. How did you do it?
Social media is everything to me. My brand is all about pop culture, grassroots, totally integrating marketing and design, knowing the customer. And thank God I built this brand in an era of social media.
Could you have been as successful without it?
I don't think so, because the whole point is I'm a woman. I wear the shoes. I can Instagram a picture of me in my shoes. Someone can see that. They can be inspired by it. They can go to RuthieDavis.com and purchase it. There's no middleman.
Do you think there's an opportunity to build a luxury shoe industry in America? Allen Edmonds makes shoes in America. They're men's shoes, obviously dress shoes. But I think, for example, of my friend Emma Willis. She's the only female shirt maker on German Street, right? The heart of the shirt industry in Britain. And she decided to open up a factory in Britain so that she could make made in the UK shirts instead of having to outsource the production to India or to Peru or to Turkey or wherever. Could you do that here?
I think we could, and I would love that because I'd spend less hours on a plane. I would encourage that. I think that difficulty with shoes is they're really, really hard to make. There's a lot of technical. It's like making cars or buildings. There's molds, there's lasts. It's very specific. So shoe factories, it takes a long time to build that, you know.
Expertise.
To build that expertise. And, you know, we did have it in America for a while. And there are some classic brands that were made in America. But it moved overseas when the pricing obviously was so much better. And then Italy's always just been luxury shoes. It's like, it's just the romance, you know, wine, women, and shoes. I don't know. There's something about Italy.
Do you want to go brick and mortar? You've got so much success with RizzyDavis.com. Why open a store? That amount of money is massive.
Because you always need a home for a brand, literally like a brick and mortar home, so people can walk in, touch, see, smell the brand. This is the world of Ruthie Davis, and that is my ultimate goal. I started with the shoes. Like, I always build an outfit from the ground up, and I do plan on building Ruthie Davis from the ground up, and I plan to do a full lifestyle brand with apparel, with bags, with, you know, jewelry, but I wanted to start with some solid footing, no pun intended, and the stores are absolutely in the plan, and in 2015, hopefully the first one in New York City.
Was it extra bold to go straight into luxury, where it's cost you more money to produce and it's a much smaller market? Couldn't you have made a bigger splash if you would have gone mass market to begin with?
Yes, yes, and I could have done that, and the reason I didn't is because I had a passion for very particular shoes that are amazing, and it has to, in order to make them that price, they're going to be expensive. I wanted to build in the details. I love the details, and it has to cost something.
Well,
I have a passion for
which brings me to an important question: how much do they cost?
Well, I do have sneakers as well. So my entry-level price point is about $398, and we go all the way up to a Swarovski element-encrusted shoe can be upwards of $2,000.
So $2,000 bucks.
Well, that's with a lot of Swarovski crystals on it.
What about boots? Do you make boots?
Oh yes, we make boots, and you know they're usually, you know, if it's a leather boot, over $1,000. You know, $1,200. Just depends if it's a bootie or a tall boot. But it's, you know, it's worth it. And
it's a handmade product, right?
It's a handmade product. And, I mean, they will last forever. And I do try to build in a timelessness to my shoes so
because
that they don't go out of style
right here,
too quickly.
If I think of one thing, one word to describe this shoe, I would say timeless.
No, seriously. You can always use a runner on a wedge.
Yes, you can. These are amazing. Congratulations. Are we going to see them on the runway this week? Where?
We just had a major presentation yesterday, actually, on the High Line. We had a live presentation, and it was really fabulous. So that was our big Fashion Week event.
Ruthie, congratulations.
Good for
amazing.
You.
Good for you.
Thank you. Nice
fantastic.
To meet you.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, shoe designer Ruthie Davis.